Wait, but you all get lap sub massages before?
After he massaged the guy, then he just whip out his d**k and just started giving it handjob.
Wait, what?
Now, how do you identify that this is a legit place and this is one that provides extra services?
There are certain people that will say want to go KTV and you know what they're talking about. And, yeah, and then there's another group of people that say you want to go KTV and you know exactly what they're talking about.
So the first time I went to a strip club was in Phuket. It was called Moulin Rouge. And I remember that was the first time like looking at like angmoh naked girls in the flesh. I mean, before Asian, right?
Yeah.
And these are like Russian, like Eastern European. And then I'm just like in awe. Like, I start checking how much money I have already. Yeah. And then like, the worst thing, right, is like, I mean, for lap dance, not anything else, right?
Sure.
Then I remember sitting down, right? And then they will just come to you randomly. But when they come to you, you need to pay already. Like, you need to put like money in their panties or whatever, right? And then I remember thinking to my friends, I look at my wallet, I have like no money. I have like the equivalent of like $1 in Thai baht. I can't remember what it is, right? No, so I remember thinking to myself, oh shit, like she's giving me a lap dance. And then you have to like subtly like just take out the money, right? So I'm looking at my wallet and I'm like, I got no money. And then I don't want her to like wake me up because I thought like maybe got gang or what. Then I like start going to my friends.
You're
like,
get in debt.
Like, I need money. And then they all just laughing at me and they don't want to pass me money. And I'm like, I need money now. But so I didn't even get to enjoy my lap dance because I was...
The entire time you were stressed about the payment.
Ah.
The pain.
So like, then when it really happened, I finally got money and I paid. I was like, oh, I don't remember what just happened. All I remember was that her knee was damn close to my crotch and I was like feeling that warmth, right? But that's it. And I was like, oh shit.
Pat and I, we travel together. We will go, like I will go and Google strip club to go to.
Huh?
To me, I just think it's fun.
Right.
Wait, is it she go with you lah?
Yeah, we go together lah. The last time Pat and I was in Phuket together, I got her a lap dance.
Nice.
But then she wanted to get me one. She tried and get them to give me a lap dance, right? And then they say, husband, our boyfriend, they said cannot. And they really don't want to do it.
Oh.
Yeah. And actually very ethical about it.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah. Or they must have seen some showdown before.
I had a friend who underpaid a stripper. So like he tucked in like maybe like I can't remember how much lah. And then she scold him, yeah. She said, what is this? Not enough.
Oh wait, okay, weird story. Pat and I was in that same Phuket, that our boyfriend thing, right? And we were just sitting there having drinks at this point because our hotel was like walkable. So at 3 a.m, like, you know, everybody was still like, everyone's like, buy drink for me, buy this for me. And everyone's like trying to be your girlfriend, right? To everybody, right? Then at 3 a.m, right, they just on the white lights, the music stopped. Then you see the girl stand up. Pay me nah. They just snap back into all entrepreneurs at this point. They're all freelancers really.
Yeah.
Then they're just like invoicing, and then she left. It was fucking strange.
That's weird.
And then we left together with one of them, like she packed her bag and she wear a normal t-shirt.
She tried to blend in with y'all.
Then we walk out, then she walk out together, then we just say like
bye.
Bye to her, then we realize, oh my god, like she was inside with like tape, you know? Then like freaking, then when she go outside, she just wear her t-shirt and then she like got one like tote, then she just going home like such a normal person, then you just feel them bad. You feel like a student trying to make ends meet. Then you're like, whoa, you dirty. like me dirty, you know?
But there was one time that I fell in love with a server. Huh?
Go on.
The service was
on,
that good. So the first time that I went to Phuket, right, I think I was like very young, still a virgin, like never had sex, right?
What's wrong with virgin?
I never had sex, right? So I went to like, I think like the Tiger Bar. You know the Tiger Bar?
Yeah.
The one with the tiger outside, then got a lot of bars inside. Then like I think I just went, ordered some beer, right? Then they will bring out girls to play with you, like either the dice game lah, or like the hammer and the nail game. And then this one server just keep giving all the attention. What I didn't realize also is that because I was so distracted with that, there was other servers also giving all my other friends attention.
So each one had one.
But you felt really special.
Yeah,
you felt really
special. Then I'm like, I think like we were there for like 2-3 hours, right? And like I was like, yeah, maybe I get to bring her home or something. You know, then like all my friends
thought
like,
you got game.
Yeah, that's why I really thought I had games. So like some, oh maybe Thai girls love me. I should move to Thailand and shit like that. Then when my friends were like, hey, come on, let's go. Let's go to like somewhere else. Then I'm like, ah no.
But what about my girl?
Yeah.
Anita.
Then they're all trying to tell me like get out of the illusion. Yeah. Like she's just there to like make you buy more drinks.
Then I didn't know that you were.
I said this one line. no, I think she really likes me. And then they were just like, oh my god.
But did you actually try to ask her? Like, try ask for her number or like ask for her to like
she couldn't really speak English that well.
Right.
So then I was like, imagine my whole life already, oh, maybe I end up with this like Thai wife that like I cannot speak with. Yeah. I'm like, okay lah. I guess like we have to teach the kids both Thai and English and like, we have to figure out like,
you know. Along the Bungalow Road, right?
Bangla Road.
Yeah, it's like
the first bar that you see over there.
Are you not confused when you first walk down that street, right? And there are people with families and children, right?
Yeah. Yes.
And then the girls are topless standing on the tables.
Yeah.
Dancing.
It's very strange.
Okay, I've never seen them outside topless.
They are along the street.
Yeah, have. Like if you go to Moulin Rouge, which is the first strip club I've ever been to in Phuket, right?
You keep promoting this place.
It's not a strip, it's a...
No, it's a strip club. And then on top, right, it's just naked girls on poles. Like to promote.
Right.
Yeah.
My first ever strip club experience, right? It was in Phuket.
Moulin Rouge.
No, it's called the Devil's Playground. I went there on a bachelor and bachelorette night do together. And I was brother of the bride.
Right.
So it's my sister's bachelor. But like, so a group of guys and girls, we all go together, but we split up. So I went there one day late because pair work or some shit like that. So we flew in one day late. So the rest of the guys probably went to strip clubs really. And I think they don't know how steady I am because I'm the bride's younger brother.
Right.
Yeah. So on the first night, right, they asked me whether I want to go strip club. I'm like, okay, let's go strip club. It was my first time. So like nervous, scared, fun, they kind of thing. Yeah. Just want to see, right?
Sure.
No, hey, I show hand already. Yeah. How more you want? You want me to say horny? We went there and then after they started asking the girls, like they went to the counter to arrange stuff. Right? And then the girl just walked straight up to me. Like we were a group of guys, maybe like seven guys. I'll throw back to good times where seven people can get together. We were like seven guys, eight guys. Then the lady just came straight to me and started giving me a lap dance. And so Pat was not there already. We split up already. Like she girl and guy already.
Yeah.
Then she just started stripping, right? And then she pushed my head onto her tits. Then I was quite like excited at first. Then after that, it's a bit gross because she was very sticky. Like she's like perspiring, like I mean it's probably a tough job lah.
Yeah.
Then I was very like a bit like the excitement wore off, it's a bit grossed out already.
Yeah.
And then someone said, I forgot what they say lah, but basically it's like trying to put my face at
her.
So by then I was like, because sticky already and she like strong, you know. Like so it was and then almost rude really, like I was like pushing away already, like.
Then she confused.
So then I just like went down, touch and leave that kind, you know?
Yeah.
And then I thought, oh my god, like y'all would spend, like by then I know what was going on already because like the girls went straight for me and then the other guys were just crowding. Yeah. Then, so by then I knew what was going on.
They were just watching?
They were trying to incriminate me because I came late, I missed the first day's activities, you know, and check steady. Yeah. Which, I mean, I was steady, you know what I mean?
Really, man? Like by pushing her away?
No lah, as in I would go to a strip club with you and not rat on you lah, in that sense. Yeah. But in the end, they all told their partners lah. Because we had so many stories that we just kept laughing about it. Then that's what I can say on this show, right? So then I went to ask them like, how much do y'all pay? Cause like that girl just came and started stripping and all that shit already. Then they paid like, they bought two drinks, then one drink was like $9. Eh. They paid like 18 bucks.
Yeah.
Sing. Then I thought they spent like hundreds of dollars. I was so honored. And then it was two drinks, one drink, $9.
No, you know, after you said the pushing thing, right, it reminded me of my Phuket story also. So, right, I've been to a ping pong show.
Which is what?
So, ping pong show, right, they will have one, I don't really know what she is, but the performer, right, they will do things like drink coke out of their vagina, then they will put like objects inside and then they will shoot them out.
Animals.
And
when I got like hamster.
What the fuck?
I think got a bird, got fish, all. It was damn gross. Can I hijack your story?
Hijack only.
A bird.
So, I feel right, like, you know, ping pong show was made famous, I think, in the 90s. I think it's the same group of girls performing. Because the performers are not young anymore, lah.
Yeah,
so it's like, it's not like a sexual experience.
It doesn't like sound that at all.
It's a little bit of a freak show.
It's quite rude, but it feels like a freak show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like the
because
circus.
She put like hamster and like f***ing goldfish and plop into the bowl.
No, but you see her putting it in.
Yeah. Like legit one. It's legit one. Because they put like toothpicks inside, then balloons, right? Then they can aim on it. They can like drink. They can like water out, stop. Water out, stop. They have full control of their vaginal muscles.
That's TVH very impressive.
It's very impressive. They take razor blades tight on a string. So it's very hard to control. If it's one blade, I feel like, okay. right? Maybe they dull the blade, but whatever lah. They still like ding 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 ding, take paper, cut 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 cut. Like the grossest one, right, was probably why they called it the ping pong show. So we were quite behind. Because the show's just running, you don't buy seats, you just go in and just sit down. You want to push your way to the front, it's your problem lah. But obviously we quite scared because we heard a lot of scammer stuff, right? So we want it to be easy to leave. We were near the entrance, the exit. Then one of the portion of the show, right, is that they just take a... She takes ping pong ball and she like loads up, right?
Wait, like multiple? Like it's not one ping pong ball at
multiple.
A time.
Multiple.
And then she just like stands there and then she like on the floor, right? Then it will bounce up, right? Then she take the ping pong racket and smack it to the audience. Fucking gross. It's like serving at CD, you know. Like, poop, pa, poop, pa, poop, pa. Then everybody was like, yes. Nobody had a hard on, I think. But there were hundreds of us in the audience. We're like, whoa!
Nobody like.
Like after that one, like, whoa, I'm out.
Did you kena the ping pong ball?
Never lah, I was behind.
They should have another guy receiving. Then they start playing.
Have, no, so I think she got audience member to go up the stage to play with her, so. And then I think it was a Singaporean. Then he like them grossed out. Like he don't want to he needs to pick up the ball and serve it back to her. I don't know what he wants to touch the ball. I feel quite sad for her because she looked like she's like 42. I don't know.
Okay, so right. Speaking of audience participation, right? So the one that I went to, there was an audience member standing up there, blindfolded, with four girls basically stripping him.
And they stripping him?
Yeah, stripping him. Then they're basically trying to make him hard. So they strip until he just his underwear left, right? Then they really all like four or five hands like all touching the crotch, trying to like make him hard just for fun, ma, for it. And everybody's laughing.
Yeah.
Then the final move, right, is they just pull down the underwear, yeah.
Are we there together?
You were the same one? No. Okay, but anyway, they pull down underwear. Everybody sees his c**k, right? Then they will take the clothes, then they will usher him to the back, then they help him get dressed and all that kind of thing, like, right? So we entered with that, no. Then we thinking, what the f**k is going to happen next? Then we're stressed. So then we sit down, we grab drinks. Then my friends all f**king excited, so they go to the front.
Yeah.
Okay? Okay, the oldest one of the lot is the one that can do all the stuff, right?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
So she come out, then she like, quite muscular, so you know, a bit muscular. Then she will start to do some like weird shit. So the first one she'll do, she take one balloon. Then she like stretch. Then she,
yeah.
Then the whole balloon come out. Then she let it give somebody, you know. Then
wait, like, I cannot comprehend how they can push air
it's
out.
It's low
like
key impressive. Yeah. Like got one parrot all inside, yeah.
Okay, my one no live animals. Okay. Yeah, so then after a while, right, then she will rotate between her and her whatever she's gonna do, and these four other girls they will do like other games and stuff like that. So they will always ask for audience participation. Then nobody will participate. Then they look f***ing poor thing when they just stand there. So if nobody participate, they have to do it to themselves. Then everybody just look, you know?
Yeah.
So my friends, right?
They don't hear you.
Oh my god.
No, they're quite into it.
Yeah.
They front
so
row.
So they started to participate. So they one by one, they start to like, when the girl come right, then they pull them up, then they go. Then sometimes it's like, okay, you hold a balloon at your between your legs, right? Then she will lie down, she will put some dart in her thing, and then she will pam, then she'll shoot across the room. Then the balloon will pop there, everybody.
But when you shoot up your balls?
Why?
No lah, like sideways.
No lah, like from here I shoot to you there, you know? Yeah, that kind of thing. So burst a few balloons, then okay, go back, whatever. After that, right, my friend started to get a bit more N2. I don't know why. She filled up a Coke bottle. She puts the Coke bottle in. She sucks.
You drink!
She pour back out into the bottle, right? Then she, as a joke, right, she go right, like, you gonna try? Then my friend take the bottle. Then after that, I'm like, oh, fuck, where is this going to go next? You know, like, it's really, wow. Then I'm totally, I don't want to be involved, you know, like, please.
Oh, you're that guy,
I
la.
Watch, of course. Yeah, I watch. Then after that, then they need four people. Then my table just has four people. Then they're like, okay, we go out. Then we all go there. Then one girl will lie in the middle. Then we four of us, like, sit around her, right? Then somebody else bring, like, a tray of fruit. They basically put a fruit on her body. Wherever her body is, then you must like basically use your mouth to pick up the fruit. So the uncomfortable part here, right, is that I was at her top left, like, her shoulder here, next to her shoulder. So they put on the breast. I know I have to do it, I want to like fast game, right? Then suddenly at the corner of my eye, right, I see her armpit hair. Wow, then I'm fucking uncomfortable, yeah.
Didn't he say something?
Hey, why girls cannot have armpit hair? Huh?
No, but I specifically have, I'm very uncomfortable with like girls and armpit hair, like, okay. In the end, die, everybody watching you just have to do lor. Yeah, then then they will keep trying to make you lick their body more and more because like at first, like, I was lucky I went first. So I just pack it off. She just like, ha ha ha, laugh, laugh. Then everybody clap.
But after, everybody clap for
But after that, it started to become she will start to dodge. Then you will start to roll it like harder to get places, that kind. Wow. Then uncomfortable. Then the last one. Then
fun.
They attack, then finally we reach the last one. My friend kena blindfold.
Oh my god.
F***ing funny, yeah.
Wait, but did he get hurt though?
No lah, no, you won't get hurt, man.
Is it?
Do you know that? You know Cuppage?
Yeah.
Like a lot of people like to go there and drink and hang out, right?
Oh my god, my church is at Cuppage.
I live right there.
That used to be the main like prostitute area. Eh.
Oh yeah?
Oh yeah, which is why my apartment, right, was known right for being a prostitute like where lodge, they all live. Yeah. Every time right, anyone drops me off at like 1 a.m. right, you just see all of them just waiting for their big van to go to like somewhere.
So like during my father's time is that area. I don't know why he's telling me all this. Wait, let me process. He said it's that area.
He found his sponsor test.
Then he was also telling me about like Orchard Towers area. Yeah. It's the main area. Then they have like the Russian girls club and like the transvestite girls club and all this kind of thing.
But I go before, eh, like.
Never. Oh, you've been?
Not much, yeah.
Like the, which one?
Orchard Towers.
No, but which part?
Any, no, what the hell? You remember the name of the place you go, man?
I know.
I know, geez. I look around, anybody I know.
The theme one. You don't know the theme, lah?
No, lah.
Right.
As in the theme, like sometimes outside, like got one cowboy one. Like a cowboy, they all ranch, got all f***ing ropes. All.
I've seen the neon sign outside.
And then you go inside, just like that. Oh. I feel like, I mean, I said this before, I feel like if I was a girl in a committed relationship? No, if I'm not born in Singapore.
Oh.
Like in a country whereby, wow, it's a cycle and my prospect is probably going downstairs and like help my mom sell snacks, right? I'll probably do it, yeah. Like it's the only way to break out of the cycle, to get like...
Social mobility.
Yeah. Like you look at those like stream sites, those stream porn sites, what they would do for money, right? Then you realize actually they're just in the comfort of their own home. Mm. They are completely safe.
Yeah.
Nobody else watching them knows who the f*** they are.
Mm. Yeah.
And then they are making US dollars. Oh.
And they make a lot of money.
Yeah.
No, so I interviewed this guy, right, for one of our other videos, this incognito episode, right? He dated a prostitute in Singapore.
Mm.
And something that we found out that was very interesting is that the amount of money she makes is insane. Mm. I think it's like at least 20k a month.
Wow. Right?
At least 20k a month. So I think she was from Thailand. So she came over here, then she worked for a brief period, like maybe 1 year, 2 years, whatever, right? Then when she go back to Thailand, right, that money that she accumulated, right, is to help her community, her town. That she can get a nice house, she can give back, like, and she's set for life already.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah.
Something else that was interesting to me was that he mentioned that when you go inside the room, right, it's like her own room. It's like going into like, have like her pictures on the wall. That
it feels like she lives there.
I think she actually lives there.
Right.
No, yeah. they do live there. But that's the theme also lah. But I mean, if you all could do like a quick stint, right? Like 2 years.
As a sex worker?
If I'm a pretty girl, yeah.
But you get, no lah, like who you are now lah.
No. I'll be broke.
Yeah, no one's gonna watch, yeah.
No, but if people want, what you do?
Yeah. Say you are guaranteed, like 10k, at least 10k, 20k.
A month.
A month ah?
But every day you suck like 3.
Huh, I have to suck ah?
I mean, you gotta do what they want, right?
No?
Oh, okay, woman.
No, in Singapore, in my current circumstances.
No lah.
Why would I?
okay, no. No, you say you are you now.
No.
You.
No, like I'm me lah. I'm running a business lah.
Sure. And you're, oh yeah, okay lah.
Can I full time job? No.
Okay, cannot.
Wait, so you will go do?
Huh?
3 a day you go do? For 10k a month? Like right now? You quit this job and then, actually you don't need to quit this job, you can do it on the side.
Not deek lah. Not deek.
No, but 20k a month eh.
No.
Double standard.
That's too many.
3 is too many.
3 a day!
Anna.
In business roaring one.
Yeah.
I mean, it can be 1 a day lah, but 7k oh. You know, 20k is 3 a day, it's like this lah, math.
No, okay. If it's woman, okay.
Okay, but all above 60.
Where is this place? Sucks, yeah? Who's the manager? Such bad marketing. I think yeah, I will. 6, yeah. I have to take out their teeth. Then put in the glass. Then done already, put back.
Oh my god, that should have never bite you. Eh.
Wow.
Walao.
I would. You won't meh?
I would lah.
You remember when we used to talk about news and like deep stuff?
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed what we talked about, do drop us a sub and we'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.